Morning, students. Today, in this lecture, we are going to study some possible important multiple choice questions comes under the unit 4 and 5. So you all know that in fourth unit we have analysis of discrete time signals. So here the first topic will be baseband signal sampling. So here in this topic you are having more number of questions related to the sampling concept. For example, Nyquist rate, Nyquist frequency, or determine the sampling. So some technique that some what questions. So what is the over sampling, what is down sampling, okay, what is aliasing, like that also we can expect from this topic, right? So second topic is Fourier transform of discrete time signals, that is DTFT. So here we have some problem also, that is to determine the DTFT of the following signals, okay, or you have some conditions. You just concentrate on its properties, the statement and proof of these properties. Then the problem related to your DTFT properties also. Okay, so your preparation will be like this only. Next, we want to third topic, that is Z transform and property. So here you are expecting so many questions comes under this topic, because in Z transform we have different properties. There are almost we have 12 properties. Then you first of all you should know about the definition of Z transform. You know about the formula, okay, that is Z transform definition, inverse Z transform definition, then the all the statement of this properties, 12 properties definition, okay, then you should know about the inverse Z transform also, that is long division method and partial fraction method and residue method. So this is also okay topic we expected from this unit 4. Okay, so next we move on to unit 5. Here LTI discrete time system, that is linear time invariant and discrete time system. Yes, of course, first topic is impulse response, isn't it? You need unit 3 also you can have the impulse response, because there LTI cut for continuous time system, but last unit discrete time system. This is the difference between unit 2 and unit 3 and unit 5, right? You just compare these two unit while you study. So impulse response, then difference equations. Suppose for example the difference equation should be given, okay. Then third topic will be convolution sum. So here we have more number of questions we expected, because you find out the convolution of any two signals like x1 h1, like that the question will be framing like that. You should know how to solve the based upon the convolution method, right? Then here also we have DFT, that is discrete Fourier transform non recursive. So FER and IER, so filter based question also you may expected here, right? Because here we have the recursive and non-recursive node. So this is nothing but FTR and IR system. So based upon this here, sometimes you may expect it, because in this topic the questions may be given like this, okay? Right? The question may be asking only based upon this Mach diagram representation, right? Sometimes the diagram may be given, or sometimes the direct question will be given like this, asking like this, how many multipliers are required, how many adders are required, okay? So what is the purpose of the multiplier, what is the purpose of adder element, what is the purpose of delay element, delay block, like this also you may expected some questions from this topic, right? And last but not least, block diagram representation, okay? That is a discrete time system connected in series and pair. So only the two method, that is parallel, right? So there also you should expect how to connect the two system are connected in series, right? Like that they may be asking, or any block diagram, that is final diagram, final structure will be given. From the structure they are asking you to find out which type of realization of the system. Suppose if the in the question the block diagram should be given like this, okay? H1 of system block and H2 of system are connected in series, right? Simply the block diagram only given, you can able to find out the what kind of realization this one. Okay, either it will be connected in series, or either it will be connected in parallel, or either connected in direct form 1 or direct form 2. Okay, totally we can have four different methods, direct form 1, 2, cascade and parallel. But according to our syllabus, we have only concentrated and connected in cascade and parallel. Okay, fair cascade, no problem. Because the output of the one system is connected as a input to the second system. It means both systems are connected in series connection. Okay. Parallel also you should know that. It means you can get the combined input, same input. Okay. For all this system. But it will produce a combined output. Input should be same. But output is combined of the all the subtransfer system. That is the concept of a parallel connection. Okay, so while you are studying or preparing the MCQ type, that is objective level of signal system, it will be easiest for you, but without knowing the definition, without knowing the properties formulae, without knowing the basic concept, so you are not supposed to attempt this all the questions. Okay, so students, once again I repeatedly tell you, to the syllabus according to their topic, you must go through your textbook. Okay. You first understanding your basic concept, and then you just attempt your one more question. Okay. Don't mug up any one more question directly from Google. Okay. So let's enter into the session. Do you have any doubts, students? Okay, I hope now you are ready for to attend this quiz question. Okay, let's wait. How many of you exactly say the correct answer?
This conference will now be recorded.
Say, let's see the answer. Nyquist rate and Nyquist interval. First, you have to find out the Nyquist rate. Okay. Say, Nyquist rate and Nyquist interval are independent of amplitude. Okay, it is not depend upon the amplitude level, that is magnitude scaling. But time scaling will change the rate. Okay. So magnitude is amplitude is constant because it is not depend upon the amplitude. It is independent of the amplitude. But time scaling is differ. Okay. So here sin C function, that is sin C of T, it can be written as G 2 pi of omega. Okay. So we know that this condition, sin C function condition. Okay. If you don't know, you just note it on this condition, at least here. Okay. Sin C of T, it implies to G 2 pi of omega. G 2 pi of omega. So from this you have to find out the omega m. So omega m, which is equal to 2 pi. Okay, here omega m, which is equal to 2 pi. So for this omega m, it can be written as 2 pi fm. So 2 pi fm, which is equal to pi. So therefore pi and pi should be cancelled out here. What about 2 fm, which is equal to 1? Okay, finally you can get the answer is 2 fm equal to 1. So it means Nyquist rate, according to the definition of Nyquist rate. So Nyquist rate is nothing but fs, isn't it? So fs, which is equal to exactly equal to 2 fm, that is sampling frequency is exactly equal to 2 fm, that is the definition of Nyquist rate. So here 2 fm, which is equal to 1, so frequency, unit for frequency is hertz, so 1 hertz. So here, is there any other 1 hertz is available here answer? Yeah, option B and option D, we have 1 hertz. Okay, you just mark it down these two answer. Let's take another one. So Nyquist interval. So Nyquist interval is reciprocal of the frequency is Nyquist interval, isn't it? So here interval T, which is equal to 12 fm. Okay. So from this which is equal to 1 second. So therefore f is equal to 1 hertz and T is also equal to 1 second. Am I clear? Not 12 fm. Sorry. Here 1/2 fm. So here division is missing here. So 1/2 fm, right? So that is reciprocal of the time period. Frequency is 1 hertz means time is also 1 second, because 1/1, which is equal to 1. So option B is the correct answer. Okay. So Nyquist rate formula you should know. Okay, 2 fm, that is Nyquist rate. Okay, Nyquist interval is 1/f, that is T, which is equal to 1/f. Okay. So you remember these two formula, but sin C function, which is equal to G 2 pi of omega. Okay, that's also you keep in your mind. Next, second question. Which of the following is the process of aliasing? Okay, I will expect this question from you. Which of the following is the process of aliasing? Option A, peak overlapping. B, phase overlapping. C, amplitude overlapping. And D, spectral overlapping. Okay, any students? Aliasing. Aliasing is nothing but overlapping of two signals. And higher frequency component is superimposed on low frequency component. That is, we call it as aliasing. Okay, so here the condition is peak overlapping or phase overlapping or amplitude overlapping or spectral overlapping. So here, clue is in your sampling theorem. When you explain the sampling theorem, you just show your spectral diagram only, isn't it? Mostly you have to show the spectral diagram, that is your clue. Now I expect this answer from you. Anyone unmute your mic and tell me the answer. Okay, fine. So here the answer will be spectral overlapping. Okay, so spectral overlapping, here there will be the explanation here, because aliasing is defined as a phenomenon in which high frequency component in the frequency spectrum of the signal, it takes the identity of the lower frequency component in the spectrum of the sampled signal. So spectral overlapping. Okay, so aliasing can occur if either of the following condition exists. One is the signal is not band limited to finite range, and second one is the sampling rate is too low. So when this any one of these conditions will exist, the aliasing will occur, right? So spectral overlapping is the correct answer. Next question, find the Nyquist rate and Nyquist interval of the signal f of t equal to 1 plus sine c of 300 pi t. Okay, the option will be given here, 300 hertz and 3 milliseconds, 300 hertz and 3.3 milliseconds, 30 hertz and 3 milliseconds, 3 hertz and 3 milliseconds. This question will be asking in gate question. Okay, so 1 plus sine c 300 pi t. Let's take the answer. F of t, which is equal to 1 plus sine c of 300 pi t. So this is your given signal. So from this we find out the frequency. So omega m. So omega m, which is equal to 300 pi t. So I write down here 300 pi. So here omega m is nothing but 2 pi fm. So I write down here 2 pi fm, which is equal to 300 pi. So pi and pi should be cancelled out. The same method only here. So 2 fm, which is equal to 300 hertz. So Nyquist rate is found here. That is 2 fs, which is equal to 2 fm, so 300 hertz. Next interval is 1 by 2 fm. So 1 by 2 fm is 1 by 300. That is nothing but that is 3.3 milliseconds. Okay, so 3.3 milliseconds. Where is it? Option B is the correct one. Okay, option B is the correct one. So next question, when do DTFT and Z transform are equal? That is discrete time Fourier transform and Z transform, when the it will be equal. Yeah, so DTFT formula, you know that. So x of e power minus j omega, which is equal to summation n equal to minus infinity to infinite x of n e to the power of minus j omega n. Okay, I rewrite here. See, DTFT formula is x of e power j omega, x of e power j omega, it is minus j omega, which is equal to summation n, which is equal to minus infinite to plus infinite. Inside summation you have x of n into e power minus j omega n. Okay, so this is the definition of DTFT. So second definition is Z transform. So put Z equal to e power minus j omega now. So here I put Z. So x of Z, which is equal to summation n equal to minus infinity to infinite, x of n Z power minus n. So where it will be equal? Yeah, then put Z equal to e power j omega, then r equal to 1. So these two conditions will be is equal to when DTFT and Z transform are equal. So when r equal to 1, okay, option B is the correct one. So option B is the correct one, right? So next question. For right hand side sequence, Norwood is entire Z pair. True or false question. Okay. So right hand side sequence, ROC is entire Z pair. So option B, it is the false statement, because if x of n is duration Casimir sequence, that is right side sequence, the x of Z, it will be converged for all values of Z except at Z equal to 0. Okay, x of Z is for all values of Z except at Z equal to 0. So hence the ROC is entire Z pair except at Z equal to 0. So that is the condition. So this side is, it is a false case. Okay, so right hand side equals ROC is entire Z pair means it's false statement. So next question, the Z transform of Z by Z plus 1 whole square is dash minus 1 whole power n plus 1 minus 1 whole power n minus 1 into n minus 1 whole power n minus 1 minus 1 whole power n plus 1 into n. Okay, let's check the answer. Z transform of Z by Z plus 1 square. First, denominator is a plus b whole square formula. So a square plus square plus 2ab, that is Z plus 2z plus 1. Okay, I explain like this. When you solve this, apply Z transform here. Okay, so you can get this answer is minus 1 whole power 1 into n, right? So first one is Z by I split up like this, then Z minus 1 Z inverse, just I converted into negative power of the Z, So Z inverse minus 2 plus Z inverse divided by Z square plus 2 Z plus 2. Then split term is for fraction term here. Z inverse minus 2 power 2 Z square, that is 2 Z power minus 2 plus this fraction terms. Okay, so when we expand this fraction terms like this, you can get minus 1 whole power n minus 1 into n. Okay, you just solve this problem in your notebook, you find out this answer. Check this answer whether it is right or wrong. Right, next question. The time system which operates with continuous time signal and it produces a continuous time output signal is dash. So option A, CTF system, option B, TTF system, option C, time invariant and time variant. Okay, so answer will be option A, that is CTF system, because DTF system it will operate under the discrete time signal. Okay, on the other hand, right side, you have time invariant system. So this system whose output does not depend explicitly on time, that is time invariant. But for CT system, the impulse input as well as outputs both are CT signal. So see this question. So this is a question is the time system operates with the continuous time signal and produce a continuous time output signal. So if your system is, it will get the continuous time input and it will produce a continuous time output. So definitely those system we call it as continuous time system only. So CTF is the correct one. Option A is the correct one. So next question. A discrete time signal is said to be even or symmetric if x of minus n is equal to dash. So option A x of n, b equal to 0, or c equal to minus x of n, and d is minus x of minus n. So discrete time signal is said to be even signal. So even signal is, you know the condition x of minus n which is equal to, answer will be x of n, isn't it? X of n which is equal to x of minus n. X of n which is equal to minus of x of minus n is odd signal. Okay, so option A is the correct one. Next question. Weighted superposition of time shifted impulse response is termed as dash for the discrete time signal. Okay, option A is convolution integral, B is convolution multiple, C is convolution sum, and D will be the convolution. Weighted superposition of time shifted impulse response. So option C, the distribution sum, is the correct one, because super is summing concept only. Okay, that is weighted position of time shifted impulse response is called convolution of discrete time signal and convolution of integral for continuous time signal. Okay, once again I repeat, weighted superposition of time shifted impulse response. Okay, superposition, you just underline this term, superposition. Okay, so it is asking for discrete time signal, it become convolution sum, because discrete time you put the summation term. Okay, so all the definition for discrete time signal, you just applying the formula is in terms of summation only. So convolution sum is the correct one. Suppose the same weighted superposition is applied for continuous time. So continuous time means it becomes convolution, integration part will be coming here. Okay, this is the difference. So you clearly observing these questions. Okay, don't mark your answer when blindly when seeing this question. Okay, weighted superposition means always comes, it's always termed as convolution sum. Okay, don't think like that. You just read the full questions. Okay, full sentence, and then you have to answer it. Okay, discrete time means convolution sum. Continuous time means convolution integral. Next question. Find the convolution sum of the following sequence. X1 of n 1 2 3 and X2 of n 2 1 4 will be given. Okay, so you just applying the tabulation method, you find out this answer. Okay, last test also I solved this kind of problem, right? So 1 2 3 and 2 5 4. So for example, see, you put this. Okay, so here X1 of n, I take down X1 of n. In this place I will put n. So here sequence is 1, sorry, here x1 is 2, 3. Here sequence is 2, 1, 4. Okay, where you multiply these two terms, 1 into 2, 2, 1 into 1, 1, 1 into 4, 4. Then take the second term and multiply all the sequence here. So 2 into 2, 4, 2 into 1, 2, 2 into 4, 8. Next take the third term, will be 3. So multiply term is 3. So multiply with all the sequence here. So 3 into 2, 6, 1 into 3, 3, 4 into 3, 1. Now you equally cut into the diagonal elements here. Okay, like this, you equally cut into diagonal elements. So now you just add the signals which is present inside the diagonal box. Okay, so first first letter is 2. So where on down 2, so option A, B, C. These three terms will be having 2. Okay, let's take another sample. So another sample box is here in this place. So in this place, we have 4 and 1. 4 plus 1, 5. So is there a 5? Yeah, option A only having the 5. Okay, second term. Let's take the another term also. Almost find out the answer. But once again, no problem. We'll check the remaining answer. So third box is 6 plus 2, 8. 8 plus 4, 12. Yeah, this is also having here. So 8 plus 3, 11. Okay, so last term is 12. Okay, option A is the correct one. So like this, you have to find out this convolution sum. Right. So next thing is, next question. Find the convolution of x1 of n and x2 of n. Same method you applied here. Okay. You find out the answer. Then here in this question, option B is the correct one. The same method. Okay. So option B is the correct one. So next question. Then two LTA systems with impulse response, HAP and HB of A, are cascaded. Or look at this question. This is comes under the connected in cascade, cascade and parallel form. Okay, that topic. So when two LTA systems with impulse response, HAP and HB of A are cascaded, then the equivalent response is given by. Okay, so here the equivalent impulse response of two systems which are connected in series combination, that is cascade form, is nothing but which will give the convolution of individual impulse response. Convolution of individual impulse response. This is the equation. Okay. So where is it? Option D. H of T, which is equal to H of T, convolution of H B of T. That is star. The star it represents convolution concept. So option D is the correct one. Once I repeat, the impulse response of two systems, okay, which are connected in series. Okay. It is given by convolution of the individual impulse response. So HA of T star HB of T, that is the correct one. Next question is, what is the property of impulse called? That, so here the property will be given. You tell me the property name, that is H1 of T star H2 of T equal to H2 of T star H1 of T. You know this property, that is A star B, which is equal to B star A. So it's nothing but competitive property, isn't it? So impulse response here execute the competitive property. Mathematically, it is given by the equation A star B equal to B star A, like that is the given. So commutative property is the correct answer. So next question, the condition for memory less system is given by dash, memory less system. Okay, so the impulse response H of K, which is equal to C into del of K, H of K equal to C into del of N minus K, H of K equal to C into H of K into del of K. Then option D is H of K equal to C into H of N minus K into del of K. So in which condition the given system is said to be memoryless? Okay, answer A, that is H of K equal to C into del of K, the memoryless system, because this is a memoryless means here there is no memory. Okay, so it means static system. Remaining in the like dynamic system with memory. Okay, so whatever input you are given is just to find out the observe your output. Okay, so your output is depend upon only the present case. See, so LTA system, discrete time system is said to be memoryless if and only if it satisfies the condition H of K equal to C into delta of K. So remaining all memoryless LTA system perform scalar multiplication on the input. Okay, multiplication, scalar multiplication. Remaining the same only. But the remaining answers is all not satisfy this condition, because B, C, D are not, it satisfies the memory system, not memoryless. So option D is correct one. Next, causal systems are option A, anticipative, option B, and non-anticipative, option C for certain case of anticipative, and option D for certain case of anticipative and non-anticipative. So causal system always called non-anticipative. Okay, so it means it cannot generate an output before the input is applied. That's why we are called it as non-anticipating. Okay, so if your system, it cannot generate your output before the input is applied. Okay, so the output is generated after the input is applied only. Okay, so when indicates the impulse response is 0 for negative 10. So when it is impulse response is 0 for negative 10. So non-anticipating is the correct one. Next question. The impulse response of discrete time signal is given by h of n equal to u of n plus 3. Whether the system is causal or not. Okay. Option A causal, B is non-causal, C is insufficient information, D is the system cannot be classified. So option B is the correct one, non-causal. Okay. So here, the given impulse response h of n equal to u of n plus 3 is not causal because the term u of n plus 3 which implies its non-zero value. For example, if you substitute some value, you are giving some value here, n equal to minus 1, n equal to minus 2, minus 3 like that. So h of minus 1 which is equal to u of 2, h of minus 2 which is equal to u of minus 1, plus 1, h of minus 3 which is equal to u of 0. Okay. So when you see this condition, your output is depend upon past value also. So the given system is said to be non-causal. Right? Option B is the correct one. So which type of discrete time system does not exhibit the necessary or if any feedback connection? Okay, it is based, this question is based upon the recursive and non-recursive topic. Okay, so recursive system, non-recursive system are both A and B or none of them. So which type of discrete time system do not or does not exhibit the necessary for any feedback? So answer will be non-recursive. Okay, non-recursive means there is no feedback connection. Okay, your output is depend upon only the current input, not past value, right? So non-recursive is the correct one. Next question, which among the following belongs to the category of non-recursive system? So non-recursive means, just now I told you, non-recursive means there is no feedback, so it is open loop system. So the example for non-recursive is FER filter. Okay, recursive means we call it as IER filter. Okay, don't get confusion in this part. Recursive means there is a feedback, we call it as IER system. Non-recursive means FER filter, there is no feedback. So here you just look at this topic, non-recursive. So definitely it is nothing but the FER. Okay, but one more time we find out whether it is causal or non-causal. So definitely FER system is causal. Okay, because there is no feedback here, so causal FER. So if there is feedback, you may say it is non-causal. Okay, but here without feedback, so without feedback means your output is just depend upon only the present input. So present input means causal. Okay, so causal FER system is the correct one. So for your confusion only, are giving like this. Okay, so two FER will be given and causal and non-causal is also given. So this is for you, they are trying to just confuse you something, right? So next question, recursive systems are basically characterized by the dependency of its output on dash. Option A, present input, past input, previous output, all of the above. Okay, recursive. Okay, now recursive means there is a feedback. So there is a feedback means here your output is depend upon present input, past input, and as well as previous output also. So all the above, so all the three conditions will be given, satisfied. So option D is the correct one. So next question, what is the nature of Fourier representation of discrete and aperiodic signal? So nature of Fourier representation, okay, continuous periodic, discrete aperiodic, continuous periodic, discrete and periodic. So answer will be Fourier representation of discrete and aperiodic signal. So it means Fourier representation of discrete is continuous. Okay, here it will be alternate one. Okay, Fourier representation of discrete is continuous. So option first part is continuous. Here aperiodic, this is also you take down reverse osmosis. So periodic. So continuous and periodic. This is a clue for you. Okay, so here discrete means continuous, aperiodic means periodic, right? So continuous and periodic. That is the correct one. So next question, for a band pass signal extend from 1 kHz to 2 kHz, then the minimum sampling frequency that needed to retain all the information of the sampled signal. So band pass signal is extended from 1 kHz to 2 kHz. So you first find out the sampling frequency, right? For expression, minimum sampling frequency is equal to twice the band. That is the concept. That is according to the sampling theorem. Okay. So sampling theorem is fs greater than or equal to 2fo. But minimum sampling frequency is at least equal to 2 times bandwidth. Okay, 2 times bandwidth. So here 2 into, here bandwidth is what? 1 kHz to 2 kHz. So higher to lower. Okay, so 2 minus 1. So 2 into 2 minus 1. So 2 minus 1 is 1. Into 2. So 2 kHz is the correct answer. Okay, so the minimum sampling, you just noted on this formula, minimum sampling frequency, which is equal to 2 times bandwidth. Okay, 2 times bandwidth. So next question, which block of the discrete time system it requires memory in order to store the previous input? Okay, so add the discrete time system requires the memory, okay, in order to store the previous input. Which one? Definitely delay element, not adder, multiplier or advance. So delay element, the unit delay is the correct answer. So unit delay element is used to store the previous input. Next thing is a function of one or more variables which convey the information on the nature of physical phenomena is called noise or interference, system or signal. So function is D, that is answer will be signal. The function of one or more variables which convey the information. So you know the definition of signal. Signal is nothing but it will convey the information, it carry the information. Okay, so signal is the correct answer. So next question, a discrete time LTI system is non-causal if its impulse response is dash. Okay, that is option D. Impulse response is a power n into u of n plus 2. That is the correct answer. Next, last question, damped sinusoids are dash. Option A, sinusoid signals multiplied by growing exponential, sinusoid signal divided by the growing exponential, sinusoid signals multiplied by the decaying exponential, and option D is sinusoid signal divided by the decaying exponential. So option C is the correct one. Your sinusoid signal is always multiplied by the decaying exponential. So multiplication, decaying exponential, that is we call it as damped sinusoidal signal. So damped sinusoid means your sinusoidal signal is multiplied with decaying. Okay, that is e to the power of minus j. Okay, at, e to the power of minus at. So your signal is multiplied with your e power minus a, that is decaying exponential term. So option C is the correct answer. So okay, so thank you students. Within this I concluded my topic. If you have any doubt here,